Okay, I didn't do my research on the brand yet. Because,
that's
weird.
Okay, look at that. Absolutely stunning. Absolutely beautifully modeled by me. What a fabulous, fabulous.
What the hell is
this?
Oh no.
The Max Busa.
This is horrendous.
This is the MBNF.
Eliot, tell us if we're all in frame.
Dad, go back us.
A big cut, guy.
Then push towards me if you think so.
But slightly, it's fine. I don't think it's a problem.
As long as it's proportional.
Yeah, it's fine.
Are you so farted?
Wait, sorry.
Move loud.
Eliot.
What?
Let me get
that the f*** up.
You're
f***ing.
Nobody even wants you here. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Touch My Clock once again.
We're back!
Isn't it crazy? Week by week, month by month, year by year, decade by decade,
never
ending. We're providing the best content in the watch game. We are arguably the biggest podcast in the Mariana Trench.
Yeah!
And no one can test this. Yep. So we like to play games with each other when it comes to watches. And what we mean by that doesn't mean we tickle each other with, like, Tudors. What it means is we like to do certain, like, challenges. And for one of our birthdays, we turned 25. You can imagine it's not the guy in the middle. And what we did was we said, right, we have £25 budget. £25 budget. We have 25 minutes, and what we needed to do was actually find a watch for that price. Mm. Now, we did this, we had a lot of fun, it was kind of stressful, and then we let someone decide which one was the best one.
It's
clearly mine.
So, let's show and tell, because you're wearing the watch that you bought.
And after we do a little bit of show and tell, mm-hmm. We will be doing the same thing. We'll be revealing and filming it for the first time. Another challenge we decided to do, where we decided to kick it up a notch. And instead of £25,
it's the big spenders,
£50 challenge.
One of the reasons we do this as well
is, it gives me an opportunity to be like, right, let me sell the watches I don't need in my collection anyways, to let, like, a fun piece in. But also, it shows how you can get genuinely amazing watches. Well, up to you to decide.
Yeah. For such a cheap price.
It's amazing.
There we go. I mean, eBay is a great tool, and I think we'll do a mini video after explaining how we search.
Yeah, I don't know how you guys do it.
We'll figure it out later. I mean, in post, it will be there.
But yeah, I think we're all eBay fanatics, and we're, like, constantly buying. I mean, sometimes I'm buying, like, two watches a week, so it's a problem.
Yeah, but no, you've got a problem.
Yeah.
However,
I need help.
So, yeah.
Let's start it off with the wristwatch check. So, this is my wristwatch check. This is one of the most amazing buys I could get. So, again, for a 25th birthday, I was able to get a birth year watch, which is a watch that was produced on the date of your year. I got this for £13, I believe. £13 and maybe postage. Yeah. It's £2 or £3. What this is it's a watch that combines two of my favorite things.
The second hand's ticking out.
But what that doesn't work.
I was going to say, and we wonder why he didn't win.
And you didn't win the challenge for a reason, huh?
I was going
to
say.
No, you know what? I actually had to, I need to change the battery in this. However,
sure.
This watch was produced by Seiko for McDonald's in 1998 for the Olympic Games that were happening in Canada. And what I absolutely love about this watch is that all around the strap, you will find the flags of different countries, etc.
Why don't we get Happy Meals like this anymore?
I know, right?
I would get a Happy Meals for adult meal if it came with a swatch, with a Big Mac.
With a swatch,
it's so cool.
So there you go. That's my pick for the £25 challenge.
Jason, what did you get for the
£25? Well, if we just head to Eliot for a second, unfortunately, even though this is the £25 and £50 challenge episode, you've sold your £25 watch.
Look, the episode today is about the £50 challenge. And then last minute he said, oh, let's show the £25 one. I was like, oh, it's too late because I sold it. So, yeah, I didn't really want to keep it. It wasn't really...
But he also lost, which is kind of giving away who won this first challenge.
I think I won.
But anyway, what is on your wrist then?
So, for me, I've got a Bula stop time watch. Also an eBay find, really, really affordable, got it serviced as well, and it's just gorgeous. I mean, the dial is basically immaculate, and it's pretty amazing to find these newer stock kind of 60s, 70s watches.
How much eBay did that cost?
I think I only paid like 50 or something for it. Service was about 100 or something in Spain, but like, it's to find something at this price that's functioning, or now it's service. It's very, it's
I love those. Yeah.
So do talk about, what did you get though for the £25 challenge? We might have some footage about the watch. So what did you get?
So I bought this Russian piece. I believe it was a Vostok. Maybe.
I can't remember, to be honest.
Either Vostok, Vostok, yeah, or Vostok.
One of the three.
Vostok.
But
Vostok.
Yeah, lost. Yeah, it's lost somewhere on eBay. But yeah, that's the one I got. I found it's under 25 for like £20 or something like that, just under it. And it was perfect. To me, it was very great working. It was serviced as well.
I think it was good. It was beautiful.
You see the video.
It was a really nice piece.
You guys can decide with the video.
It was a really nice piece.
And thus, coming to the winner of the £25 challenge, which is indeed this fabulous, lovely coloured, bright coloured HMT, which is an Indian watch company from Bangalore. Actually started in 1961 by Citizen. And this is their 17 jewels, but they just love
taking the watches off.
They just love their bright colours, and they just love.
There's nothing to see on the case.
It's just a lovely, lovely bright colour watch. Now, the irony of this is, although I did win the challenge, actually order a red watch, and unfortunately, red wasn't in stock. And they said, "Would you really mind? My owner's really upset. Yeah. Could we send you another colour?" So I went for blue, and so I ended up with the blue one. We actually really wanted the red one because the white had yellow.
You're lucky because I tried to buy one on eBay, a green one. And then I was like, the watch hasn't arrived. I'm going to complain. And then the seller's no longer existing. So shit happens on eBay.
Beware, be care. But I think HMT, they do a lot of really, really bright colours and a lot of fun designs. And I think if you want to have a bit of fun in life. There we go. So that's the winner. So let's see if I can do a double whammy and win our second challenge as well.
I don't think
let's
so.
Let's see.
I don't think you can win
it. I'm feeling very confident, guys. Very confident indeed.
Yeah, nice. What did you guys think?
Yes, put it in the comments below.
Put it in the comments. At least it's 25. That way there's no bias towards the second prize we got.
Yeah. And now round two. The £50 challenge.
So I want to go last.
No, you go.
If I presented this first, I think I should go last. I think that makes sense. Okay. And Eliot, you didn't bring your 25, so...
So I have to go first?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me show you what I got under £50. This cost me £31.
Okay.
Shipping was 10.
Oh, wow.
So under 50.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Under 50. And here is what I was able to get. You guys are amazing.
It's a Russian watch.
It's going to be...
this is the piece I got.
What?
Okay, so hello again. Behind the scenes footage time. So how I do it on eBay to find these watches is I will put these screenshots up so you can see it. I have a saved searches, and I keep everything that I specifically look for. And I keep them on the safe searches so I can quickly re-tap them and have a look at the newly listed items. But the most thing, how I got 99% of my watches, is I just search vintage watch, put auction or best offer, and put, let's say, if I wanted to do the £50 challenge, I put max £50, and then put my own country, and that's it. And I just scroll, and keep looking until I find something nice. And then from every watch, you send an offer, at some point they're gonna say yes. And that's literally very simple.
But what was your journey for this one? You just turn on your phone?
Yeah, pretty much. I'm like skilled at this. So you said my £50 challenge, I manifested it, and then the watch came on my feed and I bought it instantly. I'm good.
What is this?
I got a Delvina.
Wow.
The dial is perfect, not a nick on it. Hand wind. It was serviced. It works perfectly.
Yeah,
keeps great time. Integrated Milanese bracelet. And I'm sorry, but come on. Under 50. Like, can you not get better than this?
That's very cute.
Okay, I didn't do my research on the brand yet. Because
that's weird. Okay. Is that a... No, it's the original strap.
It's the original. It's fully integrated to the case. And honestly, under 50 quid, a fully integrated Milanese steel blue dial.
Hand wind.
Working.
Can you beat that?
I don't think so.
I thought when you got this out, I was like, you got a Patek.
ellipse for...
Exactly.
You've got to protect
ellipse. That's what I'm going to say. For... It looks like an ellipse, or Vacheron has done pieces like this.
Well, I mean, again, it's here's another
incredible
reason
design.
You can get... This does... Yeah. It's got an idea of the ellipse whilst being its own design. It's gorgeous.
That's gorgeous. It's really great, huh? So there you go. That was my pick for under the
hood. That's to me. Really that's well. That's a 9 out of 10.
Yeah,
you've done really well.
I think it's hard to beat. But now, I don't think you guys.
Well, it's
can
nice. Now, you know, there's 9.5.
Then there's 9.5, and for the 9.5, I'm actually going to pick a Swatch.
Okay.
But what is Swatch known for? Swatch are known for a whole watches range of generally plastic watches made from bioceramics or plastic materials.
Yeah.
Yet in the 90s, they came out with a series called Irony, which I thought would be perfect podcast. Okay, so I found that the 50-pound challenge was actually harder than the 25. But 25, there was a whole cornucopia of really interesting pieces you could have. That 50-pound was much, much, much tougher. So my strategy was to come up with something that was talkable, that was interesting, and it wasn't just another boring run-of-the-mill watch. Some of the ones that came into my wish list was a Mickey Mouse vintage watch, but what was really annoying is that it looked perfect and it just said that the last word of several chapters might need servicing, not quite keeping time. So I managed to avoid that disaster, but that took quite a little bit of skill. Other watches I looked at was a 1923 trench watch under 50 pounds. There was a Psycho vintage AM dial. There was a Smith's Empire watch, which I thought was really, really quite cool. And that almost made it in there, but I went for the irony because I just thought it's ironic and it's fun. And that's a really, really good way to have a bit of a debate. The irony where they used exclusive metals and some of the best. Now here is
the box at
least. Oh, wow. Here is the fabulous Swiss cool made Swatch Irony, all in-house movement, but made with quality materials.
I honestly thought it was going to be okay.
Now look at wonderful dark blue. Look at that beautiful shiny blue. Okay. Look at that back case with a wonderful
there's so many better ironies.
That's
the one you picked.
And don't you love that little blue, which gives a little nod to almost like the Cartier?
You're right, mate.
What do you think?
Even Maya right now is angry at this. What did she do?
It's dreadful. I'm sorry. It's just.
So this is look at how beautiful that looks. Look at that. Absolutely stunning. Absolutely beautifully modelled by Maya. What a fabulous looking watch. What a lot of fun. Don't you just love those colours of blue? And the Swatch Irony. There we go. That was my 50-pound challenge. And
I was
way below. 40.
I was really excited when you got the box out because I know some ironies are like beautiful, not bad, and they're quite nice. And that is just
what may.
But I mean, if you're gonna get a watch as a gift for your, let's say, your significant other or something, I mean, it is in decent condition.
This is, you know what it is. It's
look at the integration.
I'm copying about every time here. It's the nipple crown.
This wrist size.
This is a nipple bracelet. Every single one of these just looks like a small blue nipple.
Well, you can make it slightly larger if you want. The Swatch Irony. Try and top that, Max.
Mine easily.
Ironically, you think you picked a good watch.
I give it, what, a 6 out of 10?
That's a 5.
It's a 6 out of 10 for me.
Nah.
That's a 5.
I really got excited.
I do, the box is cool. You know what? I will give you the fact that you went for a design, I wouldn't say icon, but you went for a
different,
interesting design.
Yeah.
I think you should show this to, your partner and see what they
do. Yeah, give this to your wife.
You might need to record that reaction and see how that works out.
It's going to be like, eh. All right. So last, Max, let's see. Can you beat, not much to be on the Swatch, but on the Delvinia, can you beat a 9 out of 10 Delvinia for £50?
I'm going to disappoint a few people because I might have gotten a watch that is similar. However, this is where it gets interesting. We agree that this is a 9. This is 6,
7 and a half.
Negative something.
10.
Well, sure. But The box is quite cool. Yeah. It's quite cool to have the box. It's a unique design.
I give points to the box.
Now, I think I'm going to need to make a little bit of space on this table, just for a little while. Now, I wanted to get something special. And to me, what's more special than a watch is a watch that comes with a certain experience. So, my strategy for the episode was quite straightforward. I wanted to find a watch that I could get for £25, but invest a little bit more money to get something more interesting. So, in the last challenge we had for the £25, I looked at Seikos, I looked at Timexes, I looked at Vostoks, I looked at Swatches. I wanted to do the same thing, but for £50. And after a bit of searching, I found a few Timexes that I found quite interesting. I found a few Vostoks that I was interested in buying as well, but none of them really gave me a wow feeling. And I thought for this episode, instead of getting something that is just rock solid, because I knew Eliot would beat me on this level, he is the master of eBay, I wanted to get something that surprised people. And that was why I decided to look at Swatches that came in really interesting packaging. And how lucky was I to find one that was unsigned from 1995. And I think it's going to be quite a wonder to show. Or a certain object. Or something that
box is cool.
Horologically respect. Now, I do not think anyone can find a more interesting box than this.
So, good start, 50 quid.
Now, this, for context, I wanted to get a watch that maybe is not the most seasonally...
Looks like a book.
Interesting.
The Magic Spell.
It's a Harry Potter watch.
Limited edition Swatch.
It's a Swatch as well.
That's pretty cool.
So I went for a spell, we'll show in the behind the scenes, but I went for a spell where I was looking at a lot of mechanical pieces at first, and I found some really, really nice alternatives. I'll be honest, not as nice as yours, but I wasn't feeling that wow. I was feeling like, this makes sense on paper, it ticks the boxes, but it doesn't give me that wow. This is quite literally a story.
How much did you pay for this?
This was below £40, including postage. I got this for, I believe, £45, and postage was £3.99.
Okay.
And
Justin,
there were two versions of it online, and one was signed and one was unsigned, and I went for the unsigned because I just wanted it to be my own. Yeah. And it's quite literally a story told in different languages.
Yeah.
But then, of course, what is the watch?
What the hell is that?
This is the Max Boost.
This is horrendous.
This is the MBNF of Swatches. This is quite literally.
It's literally horrific.
Well, you went worse. How did you get worse than that?
That is.
How did you get worse than that?
Now, you might be wondering, how do you tell the time on something like this?
It's on the back.
You're crying.
You have to like plop it off, though.
You're crying.
It's that bad, yeah.
Oh,
perfect for Christmas.
Pretty funny.
You've got your Christmas decoration on your arm.
So
you pop off the top.
Surely the tree just comes out.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's true horology.
Now, what's quite cool about this is if you wanted to, you could remove the strap and take this off. And this just becomes a normal watch that is...
I think it's better without this weird bulb thing on top.
No,
it's funny, but
it's part of the banter wearing this around, and people ask you what time it is, and you open it up. It's almost like the JLC Reverso of Swatches in Christmas limited edition. And this, I don't know, this is such a cool experience. I don't want to have this in my watch box. I want to have this on a shelf. On a shelf somewhere. Someone one day decides, I want to pick up the Magic Spell, and they go, what is this?
I mean, the box is a 10.
It's very cute.
How unbelievable.
The watch is like a 3.
If you remove the snow globe, 6.
6. Okay, I'll give you 6 for the watch.
But
the
box is a 10. This box.
Your box is a 10 out of 10.
Is a 10 out of 10.
The box is a 10 out of 10. But this was a watch challenge, not box challenge.
No, it was a £50 challenge.
It's true, actually. But that is pretty cool, actually. I've never seen anything done, especially if it comes with a... No.
I really want to make a collection buying... beautiful beautiful packaging. Like, there's something about beautiful packaging as a designer that I'm very...
Packaging is lovely. I'm not sure I'd wear it.
It's so nice.
But ultimately, it's you who decide. The first challenge
I won.
was decided by 12 people over several bottles of rosé in the south of France.
Yeah,
this one is going to be decided by you.
You made your own.
Are you going to go for the very, very fabulously packaged Christmas cracker? Or are you going to go with this wonderful, wonderful, fabulous looking watch that he's no idea what it is? Or are you going to go on for the irony of the day?
Probably
the Swatch irony. Down to you. Please, please comment. Let us know who you think the winner is.
Who won?
Like, subscribe, comment down below. We really like when we see your comments, especially the ones calling Eliot.
You don't need to include that. Cut! Cut! Ciao!
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Mm-hmm.